Let's start by looking at the amplitude of a sinusoidal function. We've seen this word in the context of the sine and the cosine function specifically, and it's defined the same way here. You look at the difference between the maximum value and the minimum value, and you cut that distance in two. And that is the amplitude. The way sinusoidal functions work is that each of these constants controls a different thing. So the amplitude is just controlled by a single constant. And as it happens, it's the constant A. Sorry, I didn't mean to write the same thing twice. It's the constant A that controls the amplitude. So here's the graph of a sinusoidal function. All of these constants, A, B, C, and D, are one. And as A changes, the amplitude changes. And you can see that the bigger A is getting, the bigger the amplitude is getting. A can be a negative constant as well, and it's still controlling the amplitude. In general, the amplitude of a sinusoidal function is the absolute value of A.